So the monastery wasn't your choice?
It was. But when your decision has a reason, is it really a choice? When a brook hits a rock, does it choose which way to go?
Oh, fuck me. You're not a brook. You have your own free will.
Free will. Choices. But whenever we make a choice, don't we base it on our previous experience? Don't we estimate all the possible benefits in our head? And if we go against the rational, don't we realize that we're being driven by our emotions, by our passions? Do you understand?
As I was saying, our will helps us to control our passions, resist temptation.
That's true. But when you control your emotions, there's always a reason, right? You can explain why you're doing it, build a string of logic.
If the soul didn't exist, all that remains would be your logical ship. How the fuck can one live without a soul? Humans haven't learned that yet.
Ask him if he knows what a soul even is. Everyone says soul this, soul that, but can anyone clearly explain what it is?
Yes, but even a soul has its own inclinations. But let's say your soul gravitates towards God and mine doesn't. Is that my choice then? Or, in theory, let's imagine that the choice isn't based on anything. What kind of choice is it then? Pure chance?
Wait, so you're saying choice is an empty word?
Maybe it is. I don't know. I don't even understand the point of this whole choice thing, this freedom that God has graced us with. Why would God need our so-called freedom if in the end he's only satisfied with strictly defined choices? He could have just made me in a way he would have liked me.
Play?
No.
I do. Once I played at Bats.
Where?
Effing Bats. He owns a tavern.
You played in front of people?
I got a standing ovation.
Can you play something?
How can I?
Thank you. Who are they?
I don't know. Never seen those before.
Here's what I think.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
I'm not telling you anything from now on.
Oh, come on, I'm joking. Tell me. You were wondering about freedom. Why did God make you free? Here's what I think. If I were the Tsar, I wouldn't want my wife to be a slave. I would find myself a free girl that can love me genuinely. Do you understand?
Yes, it's a good example. But now imagine if your Tsar has found himself a girl he loves. Can you?
So?
So he confesses his feelings to her and invites her to his palace.
So?
And now imagine that the Tsar also says, if you come, I'll drape you in gold. And if you don't, I'll hang you on a hook and burn you slowly. This also requires her to return his feelings.
I see where you're going with this. But it's not God who burns people in hell. That would be those damn demons, enemies of mankind.
Very well. In this case, the Tsar says, if you come, I'll cover you in gold. And if you don't, Parf and the Butcher will catch you, hang you on a hook, and burn you slowly. I love you endlessly, but can't do anything about it. Think about it. If even the Tsar can't actually do anything about this Butcher because of some unclear circumstances, why can't he just stay silent?
So you're saying nobody can love God genuinely?
No. No, it's not like that.
We have to check one place before the line.
Where?
You'll see. I've hidden something there.
All right. Going exactly.
We have to go over there.
It's not that complicated.
Thank you.
Do we really need it?
You'll see.
Are we even allowed here?
There's nobody here. Everyone's asleep. The one on the right is ours.
Glimmering lights. It's called a stroboscope effect, like looking through a bike wheel.
Yeah, I'll,
Well, I mean, it's pretty. If we climb all the way here just for this.
I'll show you. Sit down. This puddle. She's a singer.
Why puddle?
Because this is Seva. He's a guitarist.
You know what?
Oh no, everything will be all right.
Of course.
No, we were almost there.
Not almost. Do you know where the hospital is? Do you think they'll take someone like him?
So what do we do?
Pray.